Good morning or good afternoon, wherever you may be in the world. I'm Terry Siggins and I'm the Global Marketing Director for Brule & Kjær Vibro. And I'm very pleased to say this morning, I have with me Peter Kytka, who's our Global Sales Specialist. And Peter today is here to discuss the topic of our VCM-3 and descriptors. So I'd say good morning to you, Peter. How are you?
I'm very fine. Good morning, Terry. I hope you are fine too.
I'm very well, thank you. So, Peter, let's start with the basics. Could you explain what a descriptor actually is?
Yes, of course. So the word descriptor, when you already talk it, is describing something by using a scalar value. In our condition monitoring business, this value may describe a specific asset failure mode, like unbalance of a component, such as a shaft. It could be also another component. It could be of a coupling or a roll element bearing. You have to know many other scalar values can be represented using descriptors. Temperature, an overall vibration value, a single peak in a spectrum, in the FFT domain, or if you like, even the age of your grandmother could be a descriptor.
The age of my grandmother, that's interesting. So where are descriptors used and how are they generated?
In condition monitoring, descriptors may be part of any condition monitoring solution. And they are the heart of the asset reliability. They carry very condensed information about asset health. This equals to the condition of an asset and of its components within a plant. So for example, our innovative edge device VCM-3, Vibro Condition Monitoring 3, could be described as the mother of descriptors, not the grandmother, the mother of descriptors. Within the VCM-3, descriptors are created from processing raw time signals, which are provided by sensors connected by cables to the VCM-3. This happens continuously online and subject to the power of the VCM-3 processor and customizable configurations. An infinite amount of descriptor types can be created and used to monitor the assets, respectively the condition in your plant.
Okay, so you've explained to us what the descriptors are, but how are they derived? How do you make a descriptor?
Yeah, that's a good question. I mean, as there are an infinite amount of descriptors, each descriptor type needs to be derived, or if you like, to be specified. This is related because every descriptor has its individual characteristics. It's remarkably easy using a structured approach based on the asset type to be monitored. So you have different asset types within your plant, such as pumps, gearboxes, fans. They are built from individual components, such as shafts, couplings, or roller element bearings. And each asset is first met via its machine components, okay? So the next stage to create descriptors is to map typical failure modes associated with each component. Each machine component, such as rolling element bearing faults. Let's take an example. An example of a failure mode here could be an outer ring fault of the rolling element bearing. Imagine a rolling element bearing itself consists of components, outer ring, inner ring, balls. So an outer ring fault, for example. And once each failure mode has been specified and configured, a template will be created, which indeed is a file and can be easily uploaded to the VCM-3. And so, your condition monitoring journey begins.
Okay, so we've identified the faults, we've specified and configured our descriptors, and we've made a template. But what specifically are the benefits of using descriptors for this versus other technologies?
I mean, there's a philosophy behind. And the philosophy behind descriptors is to minimize the need for experts. That means not spending time evaluating either time waveforms, spectra, or fast Fourier transforms. By assigning simply any potential failure mode to a single descriptor, don't forget it's only a scalar. And each descriptor of a failure mode can be used to generate a trend and alarm limits can be set, for example, alert or danger. This happens either within the condition monitoring system or by exporting descriptors and alarms to other plant systems, such as historians, SCADA, DCS, or even third-party IoT suppliers, you know, some like Microsoft Azure or Amazon Web Services, that can easily process all that stuff. Now, the trend of these descriptors over time allows you to see how the condition of your component degrades. By the way, combining different descriptors with process inputs, such as pressure or temperature, or even other descriptors, new insights can be generated to capture previously undetectable faults, represented again by a single descriptor. By comparing now the trend to alarm limits, actionable insights, so-called decision support, can be created, which give a base for decision-making that can be understood for non-experts. Even more, if you apply further statistical analysis, this may go in the future beyond machine learning, artificial intelligence. Descriptors can be used as a base to predict how particular failure modes will develop over time. It is a look into the future. This enables predicted assessments of remaining useful life of your components.
So, Peter, would you be able to show us something like a picture of what that architecture might look like? For I'm a non-expert and I can see how these things would be useful, but what would an actionable insight for a non-expert like me look like in practice?
You need to be creative now. Imagine you are now a plant manager. You're meeting with your maintenance staff to discuss current issues within the plant. You might be using a tremendous huge dashboard that shows the status of each asset within your big plant. In our example, we will follow the descriptor for the outering form of the rolling element bearing, showing how our trend guides the actions of the maintenance staff. Now, imagine you look at your dashboard and the message is coming up, understandable for everybody. Rolling element bearing type REBXYZ in location M1, motor 1, non-driven end, in section A, in machine train F, has an outering fault. Severity 1 alert. Severity 2 danger likely in 2 months plus minus 2 weeks, which is the estimation, the RUL, remaining useful life of the component. Prognosis, production stoppages of product X leading to lost production value of hundreds of kilo euros. Plan your overhaul within 1 month. Actions, create purchase order in SAP for amount blah, blah, blah bearings for type REBXYZ. Generate a maintenance work order for 22nd July 2022 for maintenance procedure ABC123. Consider also, and so on and so on. Everybody standing in front of that could understand that. For sure, also your grandmother.
Okay. So if I understand correctly, what these descriptors can do is help me understand what the faults are, what their priority is, and more importantly, how long I've got to take some action so that I can prioritize my resources so that we fix the right problem at the right time.
You perfectly understood.
Okay, so it sounds interesting. If I wanted to create a business case, say to submit to my manager for budget approval, how would I show how improvements in asset reliability and perhaps reductions in operating costs could be achieved through using descriptors?
You will need a title for your business case, which reflects the answer to your question. In short, you may choose descriptors maximize uptime. By maximizing uptime of your assets, keep them running as per our conversation, the following direct business impacts are obvious, I think. It's improved efficiency. Keep the production running and maximize the throughput. Lower your maintenance costs. Avoid unplanned stoppages and optimize labor through just-in-time maintenance. Reduce inventory. Minimize spares holding, especially for expensive parts, by predicting the remaining useful life of that components. Improve decision-making. Actionable insights allows faster, more accurate decision-making, which in turn increase productivity. And again, remember, the actionable insights are now described in an ultra easy way.
Okay, Peter, thanks. Thanks for those answers. So what final thoughts do you want to leave our audience with considering descriptor technology?
Historically, condition monitoring has been viewed as a black art, as something very in a black box and special, and just for really, really experts. What descriptors do is provide a set of powerful and easy to use tools to non-experts. Mm-hmm. By combining the VCM-3 descriptor approach and all the systematics we have built behind it with other plant systems, again, higher level networks, IoT, cloud platform, huge benefits can easily be achieved in terms of productivity and cost reduction. VCM-3 with its versatile descriptors is a simple approach that just delivers uptime. I would like to conclude my final thoughts in two items only, which you should keep in mind. Descriptor-based condition monitoring is the future. Do not forget, it's a scalar value only.
Okay, so I've got it. It's about uptime. It's simple to use, even for non-experts. Yeah, and future technology, this is the direction that we're going in.
So you got it.
Peter, I'd like to thank you very much for your time today. It's been very interesting. I look forward to your next interview. Thank you and have a great day.
Thanks a lot, Terry. I really enjoyed. Also looking forward to the next interview. Have a fantastic day. Bye-bye.
Bye.